I'd like to say, I'd like to share the topic. Yes, it's called push hand. Push hand was one of the applications for Tai Chi. It's a two-person game. You push me, I push you, I yield your force, and then I return the force. The more you give, the more you get back. The more you give it to me, the more I get it to absorb it, and then return it back. The game keeps going between back and forth. When once lost the balance, then the person will fly away pretty far. And then for the one person, you know, and lose attention, lose the stillness and concentration, do not use the mind and body to listen to the metaphysical force. And that person will lose the balance between the body and the spirit, and then we lost the game. So anyway, that was describing the basic principle and what the game looks like in push hand. So Tai Chi push hand can adapt it to our everyday life. It's a philosophy. It's also an application in our everyday life. So when I thought about it, and I thought, wow, that's a cool talk about it. It is the push hand. It is the product of Taoism. It is based on Taoism philosophy guiding. It is internal art. It says one to produce internal energy into this application, using this application. However, it is so much like our life. Let's say you are a receiver. You are a receiver. When one pushing to your chest, you're receiving and turn your waves yield before you return. So let's say you are a receiver. One is a giver. Giver is what? Pushing energy. Attack, throwing everything they could at the receiver. And the receiver take it, yield it, manifest it, then return it. So, this is interesting. Let's talk about you being a receiver first. Everyone is a receiver in our life. We're receiving mental, emotional, physical, spiritual, the force from external. So when you in your life, you can't avoid contact with anybody. It's just the nature you are in the community. You not live alone, so you always deal with physical ring, mental ring, materially deal with people. People quite often their own different character, different culture, background, different attitudes, and different judgments against you or applied to you. So let's say you're having an emotional moment, and givers always throw in a different type of emotion. They're sometimes quite explosive, sometimes maybe unjustic, sometimes maybe not so virtuous. They just throw that emotional force at you. So that's the ego that gives you a type of frequency and force you to be in a frequency. So this is giver force. When the receiver being forced into it, you have a choice to be in the frequency or off the frequency. Right? To receive it with ego or receive it with the spirit. So quite often as a receiver, a beginner or receiver, when a force came to you, you couldn't help automatically as a human natural reaction, you immediately starting resistance. So when somebody pulls you, you automatically turn the wall off and resist it. That's one way. The second, it feel like I'm a very victim, so I disconnect. Disconnect from the force and run. In the end, always fall. Okay? So, either you accept it, either you disengage. So, accept it, how you accept it, the force from external. It is how the people deal with emotional attack. People's judgment and emotional, is like a force of persecuting on you. So, when you deal with the persecutor, you want to play a game or not? And in this case, push hand is a game. And we have always learned about each other. Learn about life. Learn about people. So in this game, we do receive. How do we receive it? Don't receive it with resistance. Resistance can only make the two forces stronger. Two forces, both guys stronger. In the Chinese, ancient Chinese always say, when the two pieces of metal are against each other, they make a lot of noises. Eventually, one will break. When hard against hard, eventually one will break, or both will break. So when the resistance will cause two emotional fighting over the ego, fighting over the status and value, and therefore one will eventually break, or both will break, they all will hurt. So the second result is when the receiver experiences the external force or judgment or attack, receiver quite often to disengage. They thought non-resistant in peace, maybe I can get away with it. Disengage without the center, without the focus, without the stillness, without love and acceptance for yourself. You ran away from reality and became a victim of invisible, victim in silence. So what? Eventually, your heart broke down, your body will break down. You're running from the fact is not going to help you. So one rule principle is on the push hand, as a receiver, we must learn to maintain or sun in Chinese, sun, mean what? Make sure in contact. Make sure in contact. Connect with it. Stay with principle. In order to stick with this person, you make sure you stick with principle. What is the principle in your life? Maintain peace and happiness and joy. Maintain, follow the virtuous principle. Maintain that principle and keep contact, understand and forgive the other, the giver's attitude, giver's judgment, giver's culture, background, where the giver's come from. We understand them and forgive them, respect them, but not losing my basic principle, and philosophy. Maintain peace, maintain joy and happiness. Maintain not to persecuting you, not returning you in force, but to accept and understand. And then, therefore, you have the ability to do the next following is what Nian in Chinese means what? To follow with it. When you can maintain the contact, you must follow during the whole game. Not disengage, not dislocated. We must maintain what? Connected, maintain to follow. What situation when one receiver, when in a receiving its form, make sure you have to connect with it and following this kind of force and maintain contact, not losing and not disconnected. Well, this is very important. Although we do not want to play any kind of emotional game, persecutor game, victim game in our life. But it is important that we maintain the contact on this kind of metaphors, maintain the contact, understand them, understand and be comfortable with it, and can continue maintain the peace, maintain the what? The center. As a receiver, it's very important, when they with one leg forward, one leg back, and move back and forth, they have this kind of, maintain this kind of energetic flow. They receive the giver's energy through their center and direct it into the ground, into the sea, and send into the earth. That's the receiver, direct energy into it through the only you are continuously maintain the following and contact, you are able to have the ability to study, to learn, to listen to the giver's force, and then able to absorb the force and sending by empty your heart without ego, without possessing any kind of emotions and force, and able to freely empty your heart to feel out your belly and strengthen your bones. We see the energy eventually and send it to the mother herbs to take care of. It's important that receiver never lose the contact with the earth, never lose the root. And this root, it is very important in quicksand. And it is very important for every one of us in our life. Root is maintain our center, maintains our ground, maintains our belief. You don't let intimidation to persuade you to lose your integrity, your dignity, your quality as a human. You don't let them lose it. That's your root. That's who are you. We are who we are, and we believe who we are, and maintain the contact with Mother Earth, maintain our integrity and our quality of being a human, being a virtuous and happy human. That's very important. And when receiver lose the root because of fear, because their emotions, because their value and status being attacked, then they compromise their dignity, they compromise their quality, their belief. And they've been drawn into that, the game of giver, lost center. Well, you are very hard on me, so I must revenge. Return with hardness, right? And I'm being persecuted, I'm not feeling happy about it, so I'm going to persecute you back. You made me a victim, I made you a victim. You made me a victim, so therefore I need to persecute you. And so this type of receiver, they lose their ground, they lose their value, they lose the truth in me. That's their root. Any one of us in our life must have a principle of living, principle of believing in yourself, and basic value as a human. That's our principle. Right? We never lose the principle. For example, we never take life, never kill anybody. We don't make victims intentionally. And those are the principles. The principle to live my life with joy, with peace, with balance, and I will not compromise that quality. No matter giver how much force that coming to me, no matter what, how much force that enter my center, I do not lose my belief, my root. Intimidation is quite hard. Persecution from the giver, it is quite hard also. Okay? In our life, so much judgment, persecution, temptation, and judgment. There are a lot from the giver. In any given moment, given time, in our life, we receive so much of it. Are we decided to be the same as the giver? Or are we decided to be a very peaceful warrior, being a great receiver, great passion receiver, and not letting us lose our value as a true human. Humanity is ugly, but also humanity is also beautiful. Are we going to reinforce the ugliness or beauty? Stay in the beauty, respect the ugliness. That is key. When you have this kind of ground and this kind of root, we are great receiver. Because what? We can receive the force and send into our earth. Then maintain our integrity and quality is our root. Our root not losing. As long as we're not losing the root, we can bend almost 180 degrees down and always come back. No one can cut your root as long as you maintain the root. Okay? No one can yank off and make you off balance. Okay? In our life, temptation, also calling our religion for demon, devil, all they do is intimidating your ambitions, your ego, your emotions, and to intimidating you to possess the feeling, inviting them in. Demons cannot enter your house unless you open the door. Demons cannot take possession of your soul unless you open your heart. And that can do is only when you letting your ego, letting your fear, letting your persecution mind to incorporate with the demon. Letting you open the heart for it. When you open the heart for it, you invite them in. That's how they cut your root. They possess your body and live in your body. They inflate in your ego. They inflate in your ambitions. They inflate in your judgmental mind. So now what? Then you're floating off the ground. That's how you lose the root. It is quite simple to lose root, but it's also quite great to maintain our root. Maintain our root requires more of belief, trust, trust and belief, understanding and respect of devil. Given is like symbolized as a devil. That was always throwing the bone at you. If you want to fight it, they always what? Throwing you some we call candy, wrap a bullet in it. They always give it to you. Okay? So how do you, you want to fight it? It looks very sweet, but yet poison in it. Okay? They were always giving you all things that you wanted. That's what give us that. Give us intimidating you with sweet bullets. Give us always what? Intimidating your value and status and ego, emotions that, you know, statues and judgment, but they manipulating you. Okay? Manipulating, intimidating you. Hope you open the door, inviting in so they can possess you. Okay? To possess you. And this is how we lose our ground in our life. So, in the push hand game is a game, so you're changing position from giver and receiver, back and forth, you're changing it. So once you are receiver, you must maintain what? The peace. You maintain the grounding, and you don't get intimidating, you get comfortable with the force, you listen through the touching, to listen to his mind. Through the touching, listen to his mind and his internal force. And comfortable, maintain touch, maintain following, listen to it, get comfortable, respect, understand. And only you can get it, man. You are not using your intellectual mind to judge, but using your spiritual mind to receive. When you receive, you get comfortable, you send into the earth, you're able to turn their force, merge their force, filter their force, okay? Filtering their force. Negative all go down to your food. And positive manifesting great energy and integrate with my force, and I turn around the force by yield and return. When we become a giver, and the position change. We must learn with a gift, what? Give love. Give respect. Giving is compassion and mercy. We give. You see, humans in singularity with good frequency. Love is the quality of human being. God, hate is opposite of the human being. You can give love, you can also give hate. Okay, when we are a giver, make sure, as long as you maintain your root, maintain your belief, integrity, and quality, when we give, we should give love, mercy, and compassion. We don't what? We don't judging and put people down. We don't what? Take life. We don't take spirit. We don't possess the receiver. Always put our feet in our people's shoes to understand them, to understand the receiver. So therefore we have much more mercy, much more conscience and kindness to give. When we give, we never return, never expecting return. It's how receiver processing what you give is receiver's quality of his integrity, quality of his mind to process what I give. You're not expecting them must return in gratitude immediately, honor you immediately, understand you immediately. They don't. And while every receiver has their own frequency, their background, their culture, religion, and what all their emotional background, they have the way of processing the love that you give them. They quite often to see, is it real love? Is it real? Why you give it to me? What the catch in that? And what the catch to that? You're lying at that. This is not true. Oh, I think, oh, this is how it feels so good. Let me take time to feel good to believe it's true. Understand that? So receivers are processing on so many different ways. Very little time, they immediately bounce back and receive, and with gratitude and turn around with respect. It doesn't. Understand? When we are a giver, we give and never expecting a return. And respect a receiver to processing in their own frequency, in their own turn, in their own timing. Do not expecting anything. as long as we understand that we give with love, give with virtue, give without judgment, give without taking people's life and their love, taking away their spirit. That is true love. Giver, true giver. Giver, and we give our love, not our faith. Okay? Receiver, same thing. Receiver, when you receive a force, receiving judgment, don't immediately question the people's bad intention. Why is this to me? Without what? Going through our processing to understand it. Sometimes, beauty is only always wrapped inside the ugliness. That's just like a true friend. When they give it to you, they sound like judgmental. A true friend gives them good sense, the true force. They're giving you their heart. They're helping you, they speak the truth. But the truth sounds very hurtful. So when they're a receiver, you must take the time to understand it. Sometimes what? Painful things. It really means a true love. Okay, so when we are receiving this, we must take our energy, not immediately return in retaliation, not immediately return with the victim mode and attack back right away. No, take the time. Gratefully receive. It doesn't matter positive or negative force coming to you, you make sure. Move your center. Positively what? Receiving them. Always what? Translating good intention. Allow your what? The center of your soul and spirit spinning and absorbing the energy. And you know, as long as you don't possess your ego, as long as you don't possess anything in your heart, then any negativity, if there is one, they always go down to the earth. If positive, my heart was singing with joy. And then what? That will return with better love, higher quality of love, and return to the giver. Okay? And that time, you become giver, and they become receiver. This is how the game goes. In community, in our love, we must return love with love. Return hate still with love. This is how we walk, how we make it become a community. demon and devil seems to be very hot and dangerous. Okay? And seems to be very intimidating to you and threatening to you. But the point is, being what? In the push hand game, we must understand, never reinforcing the devilish mentality, devilish what? Negative force, by inviting them into your heart and soul. How do you invite them? Is what? Inviting them with because of your fear, because of your ego, because you're persecuting, judgmental on this, because you need this. Let go of the need. Detach from me. Believe in yourself completely, unconditionally, believing yourself. Okay? Always maintain your root. That is your quality as a human. As a human. Believe in the quality. When you receive it, don't translate negative. Okay? When you experience the devil, you will respect the devil. When you return the devil with love, the devil automatically disappears. Because you don't have the nutrition the devil believes. Okay? The reason devil becomes devil because you keep feeding devil with something called hate. That's what devil needs. Devil needs hate to survive. Devil needs to make hate to empower. Okay? They want you to hate. They want you to persecute. They want you to judgmental. They want you to become unkind. Because that's what devil needs. Devil survive with that food. So hunger devil with those kind of qualities of food. And feeding devil with what? Love. Okay? With true quality of love. And then all of a sudden devil becomes internally revolutionized. Devil change into the God. This is how it works. We don't want feeding devil with hate to enforce devil. We must feed devil with love. It's not feeding them with bullet. It's not feeding them with force. Because that can make them more grow stronger. This is what I'm teaching about in Taoism. This is truth. Forgiven. Forgive yourself, love yourself, then you are able to forgive others and love others. This, you return the quality with 100% compassion, mercy, and kind. What you've given has no condition attached to it. Okay? What you're giving external is completely representing your spirit and representing most beautiful humanity. There's nothing negative in humanity. This is what you do. The more you do the negative, the more chain reactions will happen in the world. More and more negative, because it's like a relay game. You throw the negative, the other person throws another negative, and it continues going. That's how the world becomes negative. It takes one person to become positive, become loving, become compassionate and merciful, and to give love. Eventually, love will relay and continue to transfer and transfer. The world become a better place to live. I hope all the audience to understand when you hear this, look into your heart, look into your heart. Ask yourself, was I a good push hand prayer? Okay? Am I receiving and giving with all with kindness, forgiveness, and mercy? When I give, is it conscious? Ask yourself the question. What quality of receiver am I? What quality of giver am I? We are always giver and receiver. Is when we truly look into our heart and soul, we might realize we possess too much quality of devil. It is time for us to letting go, detach, download this to the Mother Earth, letting what? Filter out, then possess, and producing what? The best mercy and energy from your heart, from your soul. Be the best giver that you could, and that time will be so joyful and happy in our life. May God bless you all. Thank you.